Welcome to the channel. So this video is going to be a little bit different to what I usually do, which is obviously food reviews. If you're new here, then yeah, that is basically what I do. I do halal food reviews. However, in this video, I want to touch upon something that I'm sure a lot of you are aware of about a obviously situation that's going on in the Middle East. The main point of this video is I want to be able to raise some awareness about what you can do to help the Palestinian people. There are quite a few different things you can do, and in this video I'm actually going to show you, well, spoiler alert, one of the things is obviously attending protests, which I will show you later in this video. I don't want to go into details about the long-standing history about the Israel and Palestine issue. However, what I don't want to do is say that it is a complex issue. Calling it a complex issue is a way for people to hide behind the atrocities that Israel is committing towards the Palestinian people. At the heart of this issue in today's current day and age, this is a humanitarian issue. Right now, the Palestinian people need our help. They need governments to speak out against the ethnic cleansing and genocide that's been committed in Gaza. They need the occupation to be lifted. They need to allow the aid to go in. And Israel needs to be held accountable for the war crimes that it's committing continuously against the Palestinian people. So, without getting into too much of that, because I don't want to go down the political route, I just want to tell you how you can help. So here are some suggestions I recommend you should do starting today. And some of the other issues maybe you can do slowly as you incorporate it into your life, because they are some lifestyle issues. So the first thing I recommend people to do, which a lot of you probably are already doing, is create awareness. Now you can create awareness in multiple ways. However, the first thing you should do, like a lot of people have done, is create awareness through your social media pages. Share posts, share talks, share posts that you may see that are informative, share comments, share videos. Make sure you are going to social media through your TikTok, through your Instagram. Make sure you are getting the message out there, because unfortunately, there are still a lot of people that do not understand this issue and they do not realize the severity of the attack that Israel is committing against the Palestinian people. So that's number one. And also, remember, we can create awareness not just through social media, we can also create awareness by getting in healthy discussions with our colleagues or our friends who may not understand, again, the issue. And also speaking out against any injustices that you may come across in your day-to-day life. But also remember to always be non-violent, peaceful, and make sure you represent the Muslim people and the Palestinian people and the people that care about human rights in the right way, which I'm sure a lot of people do anyway. But I have to say it because I'm sure someone's going to come in the comments and say, like, oh my God, you're trying to spread hate. But we know the people that really care about the issue know that that's not what this is about at all. And the second thing you can do, which kind of ties in the first thing, is not only creating awareness, but take action. Action could come in many forms. And one of those forms is protesting. Protesting is incredibly important. It gives a clear message, not just to the government, but also to the people that don't understand about this issue, what you're fighting for, why they should be joining in this fight too. And the people of Palestine know about our protest, and trust me, we've heard multiple accounts. They really, really, really appreciate it. It honestly is probably one of the only things at the moment that's giving them hope, is that they know that people across the whole world are protesting, calling out their governments and calling out the genocide that Israel is committing. Now, when it comes to action, you can of course get into other forms of actions as well, like joining campaigns, writing to your local MP, signing petitions. There's various things you should do, and you really need to go down that list. And the last thing when it comes to taking action, if you can, make sure, please, please make sure you donate as little or as much as you can. Currently, Israel is now finally allowing aid in. However, it's very, very, very limited. It's actually still very sickening how much aid they're actually allowing to go in. But you need to still donate, because eventually when they are going to allow all the aid to go in, they are going to need as much help as they can. Finally, a third point that I think is more of a lifestyle choice, and I think it's probably going to be the one that hurts Israel the most, which is boycotting. You have to boycott companies that support Israel through indirect measures or directly. Indirect can be obviously stuff like maybe companies that own Israeli companies, so as a subsidiary, or direct is either giving donations, which a lot of companies do, or having these businesses actually operate in Israel as well. So find a list and start boycotting. I say it's a lifestyle choice because there is a lot of places, but hopefully I don't get any form of ban from this. But the main ones that we're currently boycotting, and it's making an effect, is Starbucks, McDonald's, and Disney. And of course, Coca-Cola. You can actually go online now, check their stocks, and they have dropped. This is what we need to do where it hurts them financially, because unfortunately the world revolves around money, and that sometimes is the only way to get our message across in a peaceful way, of course, because remember, non-violence, when you're attending the protest, when you're speaking to people, it comes from a point of education, it comes from a point of peace, and it comes from a point that they can't throw any ammo back at us, because ultimately there's a lot of people against us. When it comes to the West and governments, they're on the side of Israel, and it's quite difficult to open up dialogue with people that maybe listen to everything that they say. So those are the main things that I recommend you guys doing. In this video, I'm actually going to be attending a protest that's happening in Manchester. This specific protest will be actually outside the BBC HQ in Media City, because they have been complicit and they have blood on their hands for deliberately telling lies and not telling the truth of the whole story. It's not just a matter of siding with an occupying force such as Israel, it's also siding with a government that is okay and publicly okay with committing genocide and ethnic cleansing and displacing millions of people from their homeland. So I will be attending that protest. However, after, I want to go to a Palestinian restaurant, because I realised this is a food page and I need to start eating food from different cuisines, because I enjoy doing that, and I do not have a single Palestinian restaurant place that I've been to here, and I've been eating out for a long time. I eat from all around the world. I've not had any Palestinian cuisine. So there's a place called Beiti, which I heard is in Windsor Road. So I'm going to go there after the protest and hopefully show off some Palestinian food. Maybe for some of you, it may also be the first time you see some. So hopefully I enjoy it. I already know I'm going to enjoy it, because I had a quick look at the type of food they have, and it is the sort of food that I like. So yeah, I hope the first part of this video was a bit helpful. I'm happy to give more information on my other platforms. I've been sharing stuff daily. So if you need some more clarity about how you can help the Palestinian people, please let me know. I'll try and find more things you can do. But for now, let's go. Let's attend this march. Let's attend this protest. And I'll show you guys. Hopefully it's a big turnout. I have a feeling it's going to be a really big turnout. So let's go.
So in Media City now, just going to make my way to the protest. I don't know exactly where it is. So I'm just listening out for the chant. So I think it's in the right direction. But yeah, let's go now.
Occupation no more! Shame on you! Shame on you! Occupation no more!
1, 6, 7, 8!
Israel is a terrorist state!
Oppressors everywhere! We will stand together! We will be united!
Really, really good turnout from people from across different backgrounds, different locations, different ethnicities, families are here, different religions. Honestly, really, really good turnout. So yeah, absolutely amazing turnout. I have to head off now, unfortunately. I'm going to be going to Windsor Road to Beiti. I want to just let you know that if you've got any protests coming up, please make sure you attend. Obviously stay civil, be peaceful, don't be violent, but that goes without saying, I'm sure everyone does that anyway. But please make your voice heard. Protests are incredibly important, and when you go there, you will feel the passion, you'll feel the care from everyone, and you'll want to continue doing good work. Don't just sit at home. Obviously make dua, we always have to make dua, we have to pray, but we have to follow with action as well.
Heading now to Beiti to try out some Palestinian food. There's one in Disbury, it's actually closed. The one that you want to go to is further down the road. It's on the same road. I think they've changed location, I'm not sure why. But yeah, let's go there. This will be my first time checking out some Palestinian food as well. So I want to use this opportunity to educate myself a little bit about the Palestinian cuisine, because I don't really know anything about it. So yeah, let's go. Okay, it's a little bit confusing. Turns out that isn't the one. I don't know where that was, because I've just went there. It's just someone's house. There's one on Didsbury, and then the map tells you about this one, which is on Didsbury as well. It's not those. Apparently it's Salford Keys, which is literally where I've just come from. So it's kind of confusing. I don't know what's gonna happen now, if we can find it. Hopefully we can. If not, I can always come back like tomorrow or something.
So we've just come right back to where we started. It's Salford Quay, so we're all the way back now. We went all the way down to Windsor Road, Disbury. They're not there anymore. They're actually in Salford Quays, kind of near the BBC, near the Media Centre. So go on the Instagram page, you'll be able to see them there. They've got the address there. So let's make our way now. You know what? Salford Quays, or Media City, wherever it is, it's actually really nice. It's actually quite cool looking. I might have to start exploring a little bit more here. There's apparently a food market that's got like loads of different types of cuisine there, and I'm hoping that there'll be a lot of halal stuff, so I'll be checking that as well. But for today, we're gonna check out some Palestinian food. Yeah, this was a bit of a fail. I thought I was going to a restaurant and record this video. I'm not gonna be able to do that here. It's like a food court, so I think this is the market I was referring to, so yeah, we'll see what we can do. Yeah, I had to order some fries because, yeah, I've just, you know what, no matter what I get, no matter what cuisine it is, I need fries. And then look at this, this looks amazing. I've got two pieces of chicken in here, got some bread stuff. I've got completely forgotten what this all is, but we're going to eat it, we're going to enjoy it, and hopefully, enjoy it. And then we've got some of the Palestinian, like, yogurt type sauce thing. Again, I've forgotten the name for this. I'm going to write it all down in the description. Guys, so yeah, I've got this behind the camera. She's multitasking right now. She's doing two different types of shots, two different phones, so I'm going to be very quick. So I'm going to show, I'm going to point it towards the camera, but that literally just came straight off the bone. I don't know which camera to show it off, but that, super soft. It's got loads of stuff here. I don't know exactly what everything is. So we've got some of the bread, we've got some chicken, and we've got this like layer in the middle. I'm going to put all the names down. I've completely forgotten all the stuff, all the names for this. And we've got some like the sort of tzatziki type sauce.
This is really bad on my side. My recording.
Oh no, it's fine. I'm gonna keep that in. This is really bad, it's like, it's fine. We're making it nitty, gritty, that sort of stuff. That is very delicious. Chicken is super soft. It's got some like sweetness in that sauce. It's like a saute of like onions or something. Honestly, why have I not had this sooner? That is bloody delicious.
You know what? Subhanallah, we get to finish with a good Palestinian meal. Do you know what
exactly
I mean?
What this you said there. Subhanallah, we've got to enjoy a really, really good Palestinian dish. I don't know about you guys, but this is my first time having some Palestinian food, so I think from now on, I'm definitely going to try and get some more exposure, show more of their food, because that is absolutely delicious.
You
can't forget the chips as well. These chips actually look really good, and then obviously a bit more of that tzatziki sauce as well.
So yeah, let's skip the...
I know they're just fries, but they're actually really good, man. They're really potatoey, they're fluffy, a bit crispy. Those are delicious too. So this got like a lamb dish here. It honestly looks really good. It looks really soft. Fizz, what are your thoughts on this dish?
I think it tastes like bilal, very similar. It's nice.
Let's give it a go. So yeah, I apologize for all the angles. It is super busy in here. Didn't go exactly the way I wanted it to, but... completely agree. It does taste like bilal. I do think my dish is a lot nicer, and I think the tzatziki type sauce they give with it, that will make that even nicer. So that is the end of the video. Apologies, I completely forgot to record an outro for this video. That protest that I showed in this video, or that day, was actually like 2, maybe 3 weeks ago, so that was a long time ago. I've been to 2 protests since, however there is one more coming up. A really big one on the 11th this month. So if you're watching this video, hopefully you are this week. The coming up Saturday is going to be the 11th of November. There will be a protest in London. We're hoping to hit at least 1 million people. So if you see this, I urge you, please, if you want to do something good, you want to help the cause as much as you can, please make sure you show up for the protest this Saturday. Also, there's a lot of rhetoric from Suella Braverman about it being a hate march. We know why she said that, truly, without sounding controversial. She's basically trying to give the go-ahead for a lot of these right-wing extremists to show up on that day and cause a lot of problems and disturbances, because the truth is, these protests have been in talks with the Met Police for many weeks. They've got planned routes. It's nowhere near the cenotaph. It's also 2 hours after... the minutes of silence. Sorry about that noise, my kitten, that's my cat. And also, sorry, it's on Armistice Day, not Remembrance Day. So Remembrance Day is on the Sunday where there's no protests planned whatsoever. And on Armistice Day, and it's also nowhere near the cenotaph. So it's just a weird thing for her to say. And the only reason why I feel like she would have said that is to cause some disturbances, and also for her to basically give the right wing extremist groups go ahead to basically show up that day and cause as much problem as they can. But we're not going to let that stop us. We're going to show up, we're going to go, and hopefully we hit 1 million. The last one I did in London, there was 500,000 of us, which was an amazing turnout. So hopefully this one is going to be even bigger. But thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you learned something. I hope you got to see Palestinian food and maybe it inspired you to try some. Like I said, I'm going to go to more, hopefully. I really enjoyed the food, and I do want to discover more places to eat from that are Palestinian owned. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you all on that next video. Peace.